Here we go. They're going to kick the field goal. Good hold. And the kick is blocked. Appalachian State has stunned the college football world.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Subway Alumni Show. I'm your host, Eric, and this is my brother, Sprout. And you're watching Mr. Liquid Bread. Stay tuned for some good stuff.
Fuck Michigan.
Yeah, welcome to the Mr. Liquid Bread Show. I am your host, Mr. Liquid Bread. So in this episode, we will be doing a beer from Bend, Oregon. Yes, that Bend. Not South Bend, not North Bend, but just plain normal, up the fucking middle, Bend, Oregon. The brewery that we'll be visiting tonight is Crux Fermentation Project. Awesome name for a brewery. You don't even know it's a brewery, though. You almost think it's some kind of collaboration between some kind of like pharmaceutical laboratories or something like that. It's a wacky name, but you know what? I really like it. It's original. I like original. So the brewmaster at Crux Fermentation Project, Larry Sider, has written up a little bit of information here about his brewery. It's kind of cool. He and his team are always in the pursuit of the next great beer. Beer that defies taste profiles with its complexity and creativity. We've designed our brewery to allow for non-traditional brewing methods like decoction mashing, open fermentation, oak barrel aging, wild yeast strains, and experimental hops. All those you're probably familiar with, except for one. The one I had to actually Google and look up, and that's decoction mashing. Now right there, it kind of blows your mind. How the hell they're gonna get multi-step, multi-temperature mashes? Somehow that makes the beer a little bit drier. Usually they use it with kind of German style beers. I'm not gonna do a German beer. Boys and girls from the West Coast, all the people in Seattle like Sean Kemp, or down in Oregon. That's Oregon, right? Not Oregon. Like Gary Payton. I'm gonna blow your mind with a double IPA called Half Hitch from Crux Fermentation Project. So as you can see here on the label, it's got a bunch of little knots all over it. And on the back, it's got a write-up that kind of explains what those knots stand for. Hops climb up twine that's just loosely tied to the trellis with a half-hitch knot. Thus the name, half-hitch. And this Imperial IPA is just loosely tied to tradition. The mosaic hop imparts surprisingly floral aromas instead of the more expected grapefruity notes. On the palate, complex layers of flavors might remind you of guava, mango, stone fruit, fucking stone fruit again, fuck, and lemon, unraveling your idea of what an Imperial IPA should be. This is a 375 milliliter bottle. You don't see these that often in the United States. I like that.
I like it a lot.
It's also a 9.5% ABV beer and 80 IBUs. And on the front, technically, it's labeled an Imperial Mosaic India Pale Ale. Now, I don't know if there's really a category called Imperial Mosaic IPA. Seems a little too specific to me, but we'll go with it. We'll roll with it. Alright, just like Die Hard, yippee-ki-yay, motherfuckers. Pull the guns out of the back. Let's crack this. What's up, Sean? Ooh, this smells dank, dank, dank. The bottle looks clean, so it doesn't look like it's bottle conditioned at all. That's cool. A typical, to me, it looks like a typical IPA color, not usually a double IPA or an Imperial IPA. I see more of a readiness to it because of those malts that are left over, those sugars. But this is more of a straw color. Doesn't mean it's going to be bad at all. Nice white hard head, nice solid head. It's lasting. This dankness smells like, I hate to say this because it's going to sound gross, but a little bit of like some kind of wet clothes. But the addition of like green, fresh, you can't smoke it yet because it's so wet and green, marijuana. Just a danky marijuana, juicy smell. Oh, it smells good. There's a little bit of flowers in there as well. I'm not going to identify the flowers because I'm not a florist. And I don't really get any citrus or anything like that, just like what they said. I'm really salivating a lot. So let's go into this. Cheers. Oh, yeah. This is a good beer, guys. Good beer. It reminds me of some of the Shorts Brewing Company beers here in Michigan. So this beer does have a good medium mouthfeel. It's not too light. It's not too heavy. It doesn't have a lot of sweetness like I would expect with a double IPA. It does have the dryness, though, that's kind of interesting. I don't know if they brewed this with a decoction mash, but it does have like a dryness on the tip of the tongue and on the edges after I swallow, and it fades pretty quick, but a definite crispness. Maybe I'm going to attribute some of this to a West Coast IPA. Don't you know we got to put our heads together?
Make the change, because we're all in the same game. Yo, we're not here to preach.
Yeah. Versus what I'm familiar with, it's more of an East Coast IPA. May like West Coast IPAs, others may like East Coast IPAs. And you know what? Some of us like both because it's just good fucking beer like this. Nose, dank, Mary Jane, pot, marijuana, five leaves, Cypress Hill. Taste, medium mouth, a little malty but not too sweet or sweet at all, which is ironic. Dryness around the tips and edges of the tongue that fades quickly. Flowery. Dank again. Insane in the membrane. It's weird. I think it's the combination of the dankness of the hops and the alcohol nose on this that's giving me almost like a mild smoked beer smell on it. It's kind of enjoyable. All right, so let's finish this beer. Let's slam it down like we always do. Cheers. Easily slammable. That beer's warmed up a little bit, but it's still easily slammable. It's got a huge dankiness, dank aroma, danky taste. I want to label it the Cypress Hill of beers. I really do. So this is Crux Fermentation Project's Half Hitch. It's an Imperial Mosaic India Pale Ale. Crux is out of Bend, Oregon. And I almost forgot. I feel bad that I've left it to the end of the show. But this beer was given to me by a dear, dear and great friend. Someone I've known since almost like kindergarten, first grade. So a long ass damn time. And that is the original OG Wacknie effing Bloakie.
The guarantee strikes out. I know he does.
How do you know?
Strike out, dude.
Well, let's see.
Told you.
Mr. Wayne Blau himself out of Washington State. That motherfucker brought this out to the Midwest and told me I need to try it because this is one of his top five beers, if not the number one beer in his beer portfolio that he loves to drink. Wayne, I have to admit, this is a damn good beer. It's dankalicious. It does, again, it comes in a 375 milliliter bottle. Obviously, that's more than 12 ounces because 12 ounces equals less than 375 milliliters, I guess. So if you're on the West Coast, you can probably try to find this. I don't know if they have distribution where it's at. Didn't have it on their website, but you can definitely probably get it in Oregon, and you could definitely get it in Washington State because that's where I got this bottle. So check it out. Crux Fermentation, Half Hitch. I'm hitched right now, and I'm going to go drink some more. See ya.